Hi everyone, welcome back to Liquid Audio in Perth, Western Australia. Liquid Audio, cherishing classic audio. And today we are cherishing, amongst other things, I mean amongst turntables and various other bits and pieces, we're cherishing this beautiful Musical Fidelity AMS35i. Now, the AMS35i is part of the Pure Class A Antony Michaelson Series. And this series was a series of equipment produced by Musical Fidelity that was meant to be sort of the very best sounding gear that they'd made. There were some other pieces like the Titan amp and the KW750. There's various other pieces that were sort of very high in their lineup at the time, but this along with the 50, the AMS50, AMS100P, they were the two power amps. This was an integrated amp. I think there was also an AMS35P. I think there might have been a power amp version of this as well. Don't quote me on that. Musical Fidelity aficionados can comment below. But this one came in because it had been, it's failed twice in its life, which is about 10, 11 years at this point. Failed twice. Both times, it appears to me to have been the same thing. In this case, it came in, only one channel was working. This channel was warm, this channel was stone cold, which indicated to me probably fuses. Sure enough, these two fuses were blown. And so I thought, well, the first thing I'm gonna do is, and by the way, they were the wrong value. They're meant to be slow blow 5-amp fuses. These were 6.3-amp fuses that were installed. Not a terrible increase, but you know, we don't generally like to do that unless there's a very good reason for doing so, like a service bulletin or whatever. So generally speaking, you want to have the exact correctly rated fuses in place. I do have all the service documentation from Musical Fidelity. Thank you very much to the Australian distributors for sending me that stuff. They're always extremely helpful. I think they know that I see quite a bit of MF gear and I take good care of it, and so therefore they are interested in seeing that continue. So they're obviously keen to support me in what I'm doing here, running this this quite specialised business that I run here in Perth, Western Australia. Anyway, back to the story. Two blown fuses, replace them with the correct rated fuses, ran it up, power's up okay, no problem. There's nothing terminal wrong here, but the fact that this, I don't know if you can see, this fuse block or fuse holder, if I can get it to focus, you'll see that it is a bit charred. It's gone black here at this end, and this one's sort of a little darker here at this end. And it's interesting, I ran the amp for sort of 10, 15 minutes, and sure enough, these were quite warm. Now, that indicates that there's possibly something not right with these fuse holders in the first place. They may be of poor quality, they may have a high DCR or, you know, greater than expected DC resistance for whatever reason. It can also come about through them being dirty, but whatever's happening, there's too much voltage drop across this fuse or in this vicinity of the board, and therefore it's getting too warm. Now, there's a resistive drop, it's dissipating power as heat. That's no good, we don't want that. So my first thing is to remove this whole board and actually replace all four of these with brand new, you know, very similar type, but rated for the, you know, in this case, I'm going to have them, the ones I've bought are rated for 6.3 amps, which is more than these fuses will ever see. And, you know, we're going to replace these with brand new holders that hopefully will have the suitably milliohm low DCR that they should have. And we'll also be able to inspect at that point anything on the underside of this board. I've actually loosened this board. This is about to come out, or it will soon, once I've sort of released some other bits and pieces. This whole amp will come out, a whole board I should say will come out, and then we can get stuck into it. The other thing I did, I reflowed these diode bridges. I don't know if you can see that, but as the amp was, as it came in, these joints were not really good at all. So I removed all the solder from those and reflowed them with proper leaded solder of a very high quality, and that has certainly helped. But there's something about this area that's not right. I'm wondering whether on the back of the board here we're going to see some dry joint around this fuse holder. I think we probably will, given that it's been so warm for such a long period of time. It's not normal. for this to happen, but it is a sign that something in this area of the board is not happy. And the only way that we can get to the bottom of that is to remove this amplifier board. Like I said, it should look, it looks like it's about to come out. Let's hope it does. And then we can have a good look at it and just kind of see what's going on. So that's the plan. By the way, yeah, this is what we'll be doing. We're installing some brand new, similar type, but not exactly the same type, brand new fuse holders, M205 board mount. And then hopefully this thing will spring back into life without these fuse holders getting really hot. Now, I could have given this back to the customer. We did talk about it. It works now. But obviously, I'm interested in making it more reliable. And I'm also interested in getting to the bottom of this. You know, what is going on? Why is this the way it is? And this has failed the same way previously. So, you know, we need to sort of dig down and see if we can figure out what on earth's going on with it. That would be the best solution here. So let's continue. Okay, so there it is. There's the board out. That's what the board looks like. I mean, look, I'm going to point out some things that aren't terrific. Typical Musical Fidelity parts quality here. Jamicon caps everywhere, and they're just not good enough. These parts are not good enough for this particular amplifier. And if we improve these parts, it will significantly improve the performance of the amp. There are also some god-awful kludges here. Someone really goofed here and realized that, well, we've got to put this bleed resistor or this series resistor here, so we've had to cut the traces, also had to install these caps, goodness knows why, and they're just kind of strapped on and then hot glued on. None of this is terrific, if I'm being very, very honest. I don't like Jamicon, I don't like these kludges. I'd rather see none of that there, and of course, you know, it shouldn't really be there. On the back side, what do we see? Well, we see the usual lead-free soldering, which is awful, and just some dirty board. I'm going to clean this whole board before we go too much further, and then I'm going to have a really good look and just see what's going on here in terms of other bits and pieces. But I've got to get all of this sorted out, these sorts of things. All this junk has to go. It's just no good. This is awful. So we'll be touching up, repairing, and then you can see what I wanted to see was, how does this look on this side, this fuse holder? There you can see that is the joint in question, and that is very, very marginal. So all of this will be coming out, and we'll be reflowing a bunch of these joints to make sure that everything here is good. I'm not happy with that though. That's why it's getting really hot. Right, so there are the original M205 PCB fuse holders. You can see this is the bad one. This is the one that sort of has been singed. It's not good. Just got to come out, be replaced. The others are okay, but they've also heated up too much. So I'm going to clean that area of the board and get going. Right, so just about to put all this back together. New thermal paste, straightened up these bridges, dramatically improved the soldering on the underside of the board. I don't know if you can see that, but all of those pads were essentially dry, even though I just resoldered it all from the top. Sometimes you just need to, you know, pay attention to both sides, and that will just help to keep these things cooler. It'll better channel away the heat from these devices. We've got the new fuse holders. I replaced a couple of caps, thermal paste, just a couple of small caps in each board. I'm not going to do anything more because he didn't ask me to do all of that. I just did that because I know it will improve the thing, but all the rest, it can come back for that if he wants all the rest done. So let's reassemble everything here. Right, folks, so here we are back with the AMS35i, and everything is back to running normally. You'll note the new fuse holders in place without their covers, but with the correct 5 amp fuses in place. I'm actually just running it now just to kind of see what happens, and at 230 volts, she's drawing about 310 watts of power, dissipating all of that at the moment as heat. And certainly the heat sinks are getting pretty warm, but you know, everything is sort of operating nominally. Obviously you saw previously that I've just improved as much as I could anyway, the thermal performance of this area that is getting very, very warm. There is, you know, more that could be done here. But let's see what the owner says when we're done, and just kind of go from there in terms of hoping that the amp runs reliably for him now for some time. Certainly the spring contact force on these fuses with these new fuse holders is greater, and the way that I've installed those, soldering them in such a way that the solder really went all the way through the board, through the, you know, through hole plating to the other side, you know, I'm just hoping that the whole thing is able to just a little bit more efficiently dissipate heat. But that being said, of course, it's Class A, it's always going to run hot. That's what we would expect, and it will continue to do so. So, yeah, it's almost a wrap. I'm just going to get the whole thing back together now and just play a few tunes.